20 seconds.
T-minus 15. 10.
9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. First planetary defense test to intentionally crash into an asteroid.
So we get a nice view of the onboard cameras from the Falcon 9, so you can see it looking towards the first, the aft end of the first stage. And you can see those engines coming to life.
Stage 1 chamber pressure is level.
Falcon 9 will be reaching max Q in just seconds, the moment of peak mechanical stress on the rocket.
And here in the Mission Data Center, we can feel the rumble from the Falcon 9, and it's always amazing to hear and feel.
Power and telemetry nominal.
Everything looking good right now. It's really shaking the building where we are.
Vehicle supersonic.
Just heard that call out for supersonic. Going faster than the speed of sound.
Max Q.
And we've just passed Max Q, that moment of peak mechanical stress on Falcon 9.
And everything's looking good. We're still getting some nice views of the onboard Falcon 9 camera. And we should be coming up on main engine shutoff here in about a minute. So far, everything's looking good. All reports are nominal.
Impact chill has started.
We just heard the call off impact chill, so that's where it's getting ready, prepared. Second stage for engine ignition.
Now that main engine cutoff, or MECO, we expect at T plus 2 minutes 30 seconds, and then almost immediately after that, the first and second stage of Falcon 9 will separate, followed by the stage 2 first ignition. And then shortly thereafter, the jettison fairing at about T plus 3 minutes, 8 seconds. So far, nominal liftoff.
And as if you notice, the plume or the flame from the engines has gotten bigger. That means it's high in the atmosphere where the atmosphere isn't compressing the flames coming from the launch vehicle.
Mika.
Okay, we just heard that.
Separation confirmed.
In-deck ignition.
So we just got confirmation of MECO, stage separation, and stage 2 ignition.
And so this is a view of the stage 1 Falcon 9 booster. You can see those hypersonic grid fins beginning to extend. The shot is a little bit dark, but you can see them extended out from the base.
Fairing separation
confirmed. With the booster, we just heard confirmation that the jettison fairing is complete. And those hypersonic grid fins help guide the Falcon 9 booster back down towards Earth. Again, it's heading towards the, of course, I still love you, drone ship.